Second epistle of John, the elder unto the elect lady and her children, whom I love in truth, and not I only, but also all they that have known the truth, for the truth's sake which dwelleth in us and shall be with us forever. Grace be with you, mercy and peace from God the Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ, and the Son of the Father, in truth and love. I rejoice greatly that I have found of thy children walking in truth, as we have received a commandment from the Father. And now I beseech thee, lady, not as though I wrote a new commandment unto thee, but that which we have from the beginning, that we love one another. And this is love, that we walk after his commandments. This is the commandment, that as ye have heard from the beginning, ye should walk in them. Going through six verses here, we're on the 28th lesson. You can go back and find the videos and the YouTubes and the audio. As we're walking, pacing ourselves to the second epistle of John, learning what John has to for us, and we've learned many things in a short little epistle of 13 verses, 28 lessons. And we've talked about Jesus Christ, we've talked about God, we've talked about mercy and grace, we talked about having your children being saved, we talked about a mother raising her children, we've talked about truth. And if we pick up in verse 6 today, have you ever had a Christian say that they love Jesus, but their life contradicts or is quite opposite of that of Christ? And you may even, from your point of view of the works that person is living, judge by their works and their actions and be uncertain, unsure, and even question their salvation. There are people out there who say, yeah, I'm saved and I love the Lord, and you look at them like, really? You do? Paul's attention to Malachi, last book in the Old Testament. Malachi chapter 1, verse 6, God is talking. It's kind of just this light here. Sorry about that. All right. A son honoreth his father, and a servant his master. If then I, God speaking, be a father, where is my honor? And if I be a master, where is my fear? Saith the Lord of hosts unto you, O priests that despise my name. And ye say, wherein have we despised thy name? And you can go read on how he rebukes the priests, those who are God's people. And they're taking the service of the Lord, and it's his, oh, God, do this again. Oh. And that's how some Christians react. Oh, you know, church. Oh, gotta bring the Bible. Oh. And when you read the Bible and study, and with that kind of attitude, you gotta wonder, well, you know what? If you love the world, worldly stuff, the worldly words and the worldly deeds, rather than what Christ has given us, a book, and God has given us a way, and when you don't love that of God, and you tend to the world, I just wonder about your salvation. Because the Bible says when you are saved, you become a new creature. I'm going to tell you from what the Bible says, if somebody says I am saved and they have never changed, 95% of the opportunity is they may not be saved. May have just said a prayer. The key word for this paragraph is command. But we are talking about love. A word that is thrown on the radio of songs and in the TV programs. I love you, love, 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 love this. Whole world needs love and love this and love that. And you don't have enough love, I hear people tell me when I preach on the street. And God is love. And if you're not saved, if you're not a child of God, you are of Satan. Your father, John 8:44, and let's go there and read. If you have not believed on the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, I'm going to read to you about your father. Because you either got God as your father, who is love, or you've got John 8:44. John 8:44. Ye are of your father, the devil. There's two fathers out there. There's God and there's Satan. There's two places. There's heaven and there's hell. There's two forms. There's either Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, or there's religion. Atheism is a religion. You believe there's no God. You cannot escape believing something, even if you don't believe in nothing. Ye are of your father, the devil. And the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth. There are Christians out there who don't abide in the word, the truth. Sanctify them through thy word is true. Yet they don't read the Bible. Well, they read other things. Newspapers, magazines, but they don't read the Bible. Listen, even Satan can quote scriptures. Go to Matthew chapter 4. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Now Jesus was speaking to the religious class of people when he said that. The Pharisees and the Sadducees. What would Jesus do? He called them who they were, children of Satan. And you are a child of God, or you're a child of Satan. Child of God by Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. Being born again. Excuse me. The Bible orders man to love their wives. Love your wives, be not bitter against them. Titus tells women to teach the ladies to love their husbands and their children. Love is not in the human nature. Listen, when you stood before that preacher and you said, I do to your wife, and you said, I do to your husband, you love them. But there's still something about them that interests you. That's why you guys saying to death do us part, and for sicker or poorer, for richer and all that, and health and all that. You got to remind the other party, the spouse, to be, it's not about you, it's about the other. In the marriage vows. And you just thought that was some ceremony. We are growing in an age today the Bible speaks about an inordinate love. Women are removing life from in their womb so they can live their lives. Babies are being dropped off at hospitals and police stations so they can have their own life. Children have become a burden. They're thrown to the public school system and the soccer club afterwards as not as a form of education, as a form of entertainment, but as a form of tax-paid daycare. You know, you are commanded in the Bible to teach and take care of your own children. That's a command. Love is not natural for man. We have a sin nature that wants me, myself, and I, and all others come later. The Bible speaks about there were times in the Bible in Israel that it got so bad that women ate their babies. There's recorded in the Bible that two women... No, that's the wrong case. I apologize about that. But there are times recorded in the Bible that women would eat their own children to survive. What about the mother's love? It's not natural. It's yourself. When God showed up to Adam in Genesis chapter 3, it was her fault. Nice husband. Abraham. She's my sister. Isaac. She's my sister. Jacob. Put Leah first and keep Rachel in the back. Because I love Rachel more than I do Leah. And you got to get that. Even as saved Christians, what is your prayer life over the year? What or who have you prayed more for? Love is God's first, others next, and you last. That's God's love. See, God thought of man more than he thought of himself, that he, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. Love is a verb. It is action. And Christians are to be verbs, not just a name. You are to be action. At no time is a Christian to be a noun, just a person, place, or thing. You are to be a verb. Love is not telling someone you love Jesus. Oh, I just love Jesus. If I had a nickel every time I heard that. Love, again, is a word used on television, movies, and songs on the radio, and it doesn't mean a thing. And when they're usually singing on the radio, they're just singing a song to make money. When they're saying it on television, she says to him, I love you, and he says, I love her. At the end of the day, when the lights are turned off, the cameras are put away, they go home to their separate homes, probably to another husband and another wife. You ever wonder from the first movie that said mentioned the word love? The Horse in Motion, the title of the movie. It was filmed in 1878. Till today, the first television program. And how many times has the phrase, I love you, been said over the television airwaves, over the radio airwaves, and is not once truly meant? Since 1878, love appears in the movies to 2014. How many I love yous have been said just to make money? Let me Matthew 12. You want something interesting? You know why a Christian shouldn't be enacting? Because acting is hypocrisy. You're saying something that you're not. But Matthew chapter 12, verse 36. Jesus speaking, red letter Bible, if you got it, will be in red letters. I say unto you that every idle word, and idle is those songs, idle is those TV programs, idle is those movies. They don't need to be said. You want to put something on the radio, you want to put something on the screen, you put the gospel. But the Bible says, as far as television and movies, faith comes by hearing. And hearing by the word of God. Not watching. So you gotta get that. I'm gonna make a Christian movie. It's wrong. You make a Christian movie, and Tom Smith in the movie is called George. That's a lie. Tom Smith in real life is an accountant. But in the movie, he's a police officer. That's a lie. Tom Smith in real life has a wife named Gloria. In the movie, his wife is Elaine. That's a lie. Or am I lying to you? You take any actor that you like. Okay? You pick the actor. I'll let you have that. Or actress. Whichever you want. The one you like, the actor or the actress. How many different names has that person been on the screens? For every movie they made, they are a different name. For every movie or television program they are, they're a different occupation than what they really are. They are an actor or an actress. What are they doing as a lawyer? What are they doing as a prostitute on the screen? Or a taxi cab driver? Whatever it is, that's not what that person is. They are an actress or actress. Make up your mind. Listen, when you fill out your 1040 for the IRS, you don't put down everything that you were on the screen. You put down actor or actress as far as occupation. There's not enough room to put all the other junk. Well, I was reading that every idle word that men shall speak. Oh, Joan. I'm just so happy that you're here in my room. Would you like to have a drink? Here, I'll give you a drink. And, you know, the office was just so busy today. I'm just so glad you were here. Oh, I just love you so much, darling. They get it out of the script. Then he goes home to his real wife. Oh, how was your day? Yeah, I told Joan I love her 14 times. We had to do it 18 takes, but I don't have a... It makes your wife feel really good, doesn't it? You've been saying all day long you love a woman that's not her. Imagine a TV father playing, oh, all his children scream, I just love you, and come home and ignore his own children. You want me to shut up? You want me to just turn it off and forget it? I even finished the verse. That every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. Aren't you glad that eternity starts before the great white throne judgment? Do you know that every script that there is out there, every Hollywood movie, every TV program, every radio skit before TV is going to be called to a question by the actor or the actress to give an account by the words that are in that script. Every word. Mr. So-and-so, your occupation was an actor, yes. It says here you were a policeman. Lie. Said your name was this. Lie. Said you live on this street. You don't live on this street. Lie. That's not even a street. That's a television street. How about this? I'm a New York City medical examiner filmed in Hollywood. That's a lie! And I can name every actress and every actor, and they are liars. Check their birth certificate against what the character they play in that program. Oh, this movie says you were in the Army. When were you in the Army? Never? Imagine all the war movies, and the guy who plays an army man, and he's never been in the military, and how this country treats its vets, who were really in the military, and really fought for this country. And they get nothing. They sleep on that concrete sidewalk. I've seen it. I've talked to them. And these people who claim to be somebody are not, and sleep in mansions and do drugs and have women all left and right. You're going to give account for your big mouth. You got the point? Everything that actor or actress says by the script, God says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. You're going to watch your favorite actor or actress stand before God, and all the movies going to come out. All the I love yous are going to come out and be found lies. I have never told anybody but my wife and my children I love them. No one. Outside the Lord. I have no business as a husband and as a father to be saying I love you to anybody but my family. How many times has I love you been on the screens and airwaves? How many times in the world has some form of I love you been said in any language and really meant nothing? Oh, you're the apple of my eye. I just love you. Coming back to you in my car. Oh baby, you're the sweetest. You are the cream of the pie. You are the top. Let's get a motel room. You know Amon was like that? Oh Tamar, you are woohoo! Baby, you are the one. Make me some cake. Come into me. Oh, and rapes her and then find out. Oh, I hate her. Get out of here. Get her out of here. The Bible says he hated more than when he loved her. Man doesn't know what love is. And for the natural man without Christ, love is lust. John 8:44, in most cases. Listen, when a man says to a woman, I love you, he's looking at three or four body parts. One of them is his natural. A man loves one of four body parts, if not all. You don't believe me? Look at the car ad. You don't believe me? Look at the color photographs of advertisement in the magazines. Why do you got to have a half-naked woman to sell a candy bar? What does she have to do with chocolate? A woman will fall in love with what she hears. That is why you will see this most gorgeous woman, and she'll be with this most guy. He knows how to speak. Or he's got money. And even then, that's not love if it's money. How do you explain this guy is over the hill, he's older than Moses, and he's marrying someone that should be his great-grandchild? Come on, you really think that's love? That's not natural. That's not natural love. You can say I love you and not mean it. But yet God commands us to love the brethren. That's not natural. God commands husband to love his wife. That's not natural. God commands the wife to love her children and love her husband. That's not natural. Listen, when you're cooked up in the house for 365 days in a year, things done by the other party is going to get on your nerves. And one day, getting on one's nerves and the other one getting on your nerve is going to come together and the nerves are going to get nerve-whacked. And true love is Oh, well, get over it. I'm sorry. You know? Love truly hurts. When someone you love, your wife or your children or your parents, and they're hurting, and you can't do nothing. You sit back and you feel helpless. And I know what I'm talking about. And I've had in my life to have a wife go home to the Lord. It hurts. There is no love. Can I think about one of the stupid songs I have to listen to at night at work? If the person leaves and you don't care. There are times that my wife will take the car to the store. And it's not I don't trust her. It's I don't trust anybody else. And I'm praying. Because there's morons out there. There are sex offenders out there. There are people who want to steal from you out there. I don't want my family, my wife, my children physically harmed by anybody. And like feeling helpless, and the only thing you can do is turn to prayer. Love is action. Even when you can't do something, you feel helpless. Love is action. It's doing. It's walking your talk. When the spouse is at the gravesite and can look at that grave and say, "To death did us part." That's an achievement. When you have one day the Lord to call us home and say, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant," that's achievement. Like faith without works is dead, James said. Do you back your love with action? Does your love show? Do you give or do you receive only? Is your love give me, give me, give me, or is it here, here, here? All the love word songs and the congregation singing about loving Jesus, and they truly don't. There are people, I love Jesus. And they don't. They're just singing. Christians rather sing songs about Christian warfare than stand up and get in the war. Onward, Christian soldiers. That's a great song. I'm not going to go onward. I'm going to just sit down. I'll sing the song, but I won't act. Love is a word used often, but to most it means nothing. I know some cases, maybe this is not true, but in most cases, where was your first love? Where are they now? The first person you ever said, "I love you," outside of your parents. That one of your opposite sex. Where are you two? Now, maybe for some of you, you're married and happy. Amen. Glory to God. But you others, have you ever told someone of the opposite sex that you love them and you're not with them? Now, you may have been in love and truly in love, and circumstances of not receiving, you may have lost that love. You know what John, through Jesus Christ, writes to one of the churches in Revelation? Go back to your first love. You lost your first love. You can lose the love of Christ in your life. And the expression we use, go back to Bethel, where, like Jacob did. When I get to back to Bethel, then Lord, I'll serve you, I'll do right. You need to get back to where you and Christ were in love, and you did what he told you to do. You believed on him, and from that day you settled and went on serving the Lord. You need to get back to that day. You need to get all that junk out of your life, all that sin in your life out. Because that's what gets in the way of sin. I mean, that's what gets in the way of love. That's what gets in the way of a marriage. When all your junk and all your garbage gets in the way of your spouse. You need to get rid of that. You need to get rid of everything that's blocking you in Christ. 1 John 1:9, put it under the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot say you love Christ and not do what he tells you to do. And Jesus said that. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. It says that we walk after his commandments, verse 6. Do you talk or do you talk a walk? It's amazing what the letter T or W will do for you. I can talk, T. But do I walk, W, what I talk? I will do it, Mom. Mom, I am going to do it. Or, Mom, I have done it. Two of them are words. One of them is action. They are all action, but two are motions, and one is just words. Again, there are some that say, I love Jesus, and do nothing to walk their talk. I love Jesus. What was the last gospel tract you passed out? I let my light shine. Woohoo, battery's dead. By the time you're going to need it and find it in the drawer, when you eventually find it, you're going to find out the flashlight's dead. God just loves me. Really, when's the last time you were in church? Don't you judge me. Judge not, lest you be judged. See, you will be in the Word if you love God. You will pray. Right now, my family are involved with prayer for two people in our lives right now. Seriously in prayer. And they're not even family outside of Christ. One I'm praying for that, what he's going through, he don't get sick, and I'm seriously praying for that. Because if he gets sick, I don't know what they can do. And for the other one, something that they can do, medication or something. Because it has become serious. Or I can just not, Lord, oh, please, Lord, give me a good day today. Oh, Lord, let there be pansies and butterflies. And, Lord, let all my bills be paid. And you know, Lord, oh, man, my shoulder hurts. Oh, Lord, and it does. I'm thinking about that one person in church, Lord. You know what? They got to be in more pain than I am. mine goes away. Hey, Lord, for 3 hours I didn't feel nothing. And what about that person in church? Did they ever get any relief? That's love. John said, walk, not talk. Commandments are orders. You are in the Lord's army now, if you're saved. Soldiers, taking orders and follow them through. Yes, sir, Lord. Go ye all the world and preach the gospel. Yes, Lord. Tomorrow. Tomorrow may never come. Lord, you want me to love that guy in church there? Yes. But he, I don't care. Love him. Lord, yeah, love him. I loved you, didn't I? And you were rebellious, and you were wicked, and you took my name in vain. You wouldn't even open the Bible, and you didn't want to have anything to do with me. And I loved you unto the cross. Now you two are saved. You can love each other. But Lord, I don't want to hear it. Do you know how you get over, ooh, that Christian over there, oh, I don't like that Christian, you pray for him. You put their name on your prayer list and you pray for him, he'll say, you know what? He's not so bad. She's not. Amazing. And again, I read in Matthew 12 that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. God is going to hold you accountable to your big mouth. You know all these messages? Where I am wrong, God is going to hold me accountable. Where I am right, I will be rewarded. When I talk about stupid things, I'm going to have to be accountable. When I tell stupid jokes, I'm going to be held accountable. How many times in our own life we say we'll do something and end up not doing it? Let's get a little deeper. How many times have you told someone you will pray for them or something about them and you forgot or did not? Have you ever told someone you'll pray for them and then you forgot? I forgot is not an excuse. I don't believe, seriously, and you don't have to take this, but I don't believe God takes excuses. You can't look at the life of Paul and Jesus Christ and say, well, this situation, this circumstance, I don't think so. Jesus said he could have called down legions of angels. He still went to the cross. We close out the end of this paragraph. We're just a little bit under halfway. Love is a word that is just thrown out there. I'm sorry. Some love is just words. Some love, it's lust. What can I get from you? Money, sex, whatever, position, job, whatever it is. Then some love is sacrifice. What can I do for you? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. That is a sacrificial love that God gave of himself for someone else, for me. And how do I return my love back to God? I give myself for God. I give up time for his word. I give up time for prayer for others. I give up time for telling others about Jesus. And I give up time to encourage Christians to do something, to do more. Really think about the word love. It's to be a action word, a verb. And yet we are commanded by the Bible, in King James 1611 Bible, we're to love others. And you cannot love others unless you have in your heart the God that the Bible says God is love. You can't love the Satan. Satan does not know what love is. Satan goes out to gather all the people he can into hell so he won't be alone. That's lust. Read John 8:44 again. Love is a strong word, but seldom understood.